Welcome to St. Ignatius Chapel. Today we celebrate Pentecost Sunday. Our celebrant today is Jesuit Father Anthony Egan.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Today we celebrate the great feast of Pentecost, the sending forth of the Spirit upon the disciples, and their renewal that creates the Church. As we prepare to celebrate this Eucharist, we call to mind our sins and ask God for mercy and forgiveness. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You intercede for us at the right hand of the Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us life everlasting.
Amen.
Glory to God in the highest.
And on earth, peace to people of good will.
We praise you, we bless you,
we adore you, we glorify you.
We give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, heavenly King, O God, almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. O God, who by the mystery of today's great feast sanctify your whole Church in every people and nation, pour out, we pray, the gifts of the Holy Spirit across the face of the earth, and with the divine grace that was at work when the gospel was first proclaimed, fill now once more the hearts of believers through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God for ever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. When the day of Pentecost had come, they were all together in one place. And suddenly a sound came from heaven, like the rush of a mighty wind, and it filled all the house where they were sitting. And there appeared to them tongues as of fire, distributed and resting on each one of them. And they were all filled with the Holy Spirit, and began to speak in other tongues, as the Spirit gave them utterance. Now there were living in Jerusalem Jews, devout men from every nation under heaven. And at this sound the multitude came together, and they were bewildered, because each one heard them speaking in his own language. And they were amazed and wondered, saying, "Are not all these who are speaking Galileans? And how is it that we hear, each of us, in his own native language, Parthians and Medes and Elamites, and residents of Mesopotamia, Judea and Cappadocia, Pontus and Asia, Phrygia and Pamphylia, Egypt, and the parts of Libya belonging to Cyrene, and visitors from Rome, both Jews and proselytes, Cretans and Arabians, we hear them telling in our own tongues the mighty works of God." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Our response: Lord, send forth your Spirit and renew the face of the earth.
Lord, send forth your Spirit, and renew the face of the earth.
Bless the Lord, O my soul. O Lord my God, how great you are! How many are your works, O Lord? The earth is full of your creatures. Lord, send forth your Spirit, and renew the face of the earth. You take away their breath, they die, returning to the dust from which they came. You send forth your Spirit, and they are created, and you renew the face of the earth. Lord, send forth your Spirit, and renew the face of the earth. May the glory of the Lord last forever. May the Lord rejoice in his works. May my thoughts be pleasing to him. I will rejoice in the Lord. Lord, send forth your Spirit, and renew the face of the earth. Our second reading is taken from Paul's first letter to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, no one can say Jesus is Lord except by the Holy Spirit. Now there are varieties of gifts, but the same Spirit, and there are varieties of service, but the same Lord, and there are varieties of working, but it is the same God who inspires them all in everyone. To each is given the manifestation of the Spirit for the common good. For just as the body is one and has many members, and all the members of the body, though many, are one body, so it is with Christ. For by one Spirit we were all baptized into one body, Jews or Greeks, slaves or free, and all were made to drink of one Spirit. The Word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Alleluia, Alleluia, Alleluia.
Come, O Holy Spirit, fill the hearts of your faithful and kindle in them the fire of your love.
Alleluia, Alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
At that time, Jesus said to his disciples, "When the Counselor comes, whom I shall send to you from the Father, even the Spirit of truth, who proceeds from the Father, he will bear witness to me, and you also are witnesses, because you have been with me from the beginning. I have yet many things to say to you, but you cannot bear them now. When the Spirit of truth comes, he will guide you into all the truth. For he will not speak on his own authority, but whatever he hears, he will speak, and he will declare to you the things that are to come. He will glorify me, for he will take what is mine and declare it to you." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
In the midst of great events, between one momentous occasion and another, there often comes a lull, a pause. Perhaps this is natural. The human psyche can only take a certain amount of excitement and drama. Too much reality lived on adrenaline may have the effect of burning us out. It is necessary to stop, to take stock, to think and rethink what we're doing. Even if that pause can feel awkward, even a bit frustrating. So what now? Before he left again, he promised us the Spirit of truth, courage and guidance.
He told us to be witnesses. But how? How indeed to speak the minority view? How to tell the rest he is the Messiah? So what now? Here we sit, waiting for something to happen. Here we sit, trying to work out what to do. So what now? It's windy, a storm brewing, unusual for this time of year. Was that a lightning flash or something else? It's hard to tell from inside this place. Here we sit, trying to work out what to do. Here we sit, waiting for something to happen. It's windy. And the light in this room is a bit like fire. It dances and flashes around us. Strange light for this time of day, like fire. Look, we are as if on fire. But it's a cool heat, a heat that calms us like a breeze. And with the calm comes clarity, comes purpose. Sorry, Peter, did you just say something in Latin? Was that impeccable Greek, James, almost as Athenian speak? Thomas, did you just say something in Hindi? But you don't speak Latin, Peter. And James, your Greek is frankly embarrassing. As for you, Thomas, how do I even know you spoke a language I've never heard before? Hold on, I just thought I heard Arabic. Was that just Persian? And suddenly we are laughing like children, running outside like gleeful lemmings, quite simply not afraid. And wherever we walk and talk, the cool fire of clarity and mission burns in us. And whatever we say, they can hear us, understand us, even if they look on us as mad. We are alive and unafraid. We are speaking with hitherto undiscovered eloquence, as if the Lord was doing the speaking and we just moving our lips. And the wind, like fire, flashes around the town, and the wind blows it to every corner of the Lord's own earth. So here we are again, celebrating the birth of the church, celebrating the shift in a small community of disciples who, having basked in the glory of the resurrection, having embraced the promise of the ascension that Christ would send the Spirit to guide them on their mission, actively emerged from taking stock of what he'd said, and like a mighty wind, took their experience to the whole world. Resurrection joy for a handful became the birth of a faith we share as a direct result of their response to the Spirit. May the wind of Pentecost and the fire of the Spirit send us out today to proclaim the resurrection in the new languages of the 21st century. So, filled with that same Spirit, let us profess the faith we share by saying together the Apostles' Creed.
I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From there he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen.
And so today we then bring before the Lord our prayers and petitions.
May the Spirit of Pentecost renew the Church. May we be filled with courage and a new language to proclaim the resurrection in our time. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
May the Holy Spirit strengthen all who work at this time in the struggle against COVID. May the Lord bless all who care for the sick. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
May all communities around the world be nourished by the voice of mercy, the voice of God's desire for a new commitment to peace. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
For your own prayers. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
Loving God, we bring before you these prayers we make, spoken and unspoken. We ask you to hear them and answer them according to your will. And we make all these prayers in the Spirit through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation. Through your goodness we have this bread to offer, fruit of the earth, work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
By this mingling of water and wine, may we come to share in the divinity of him who shared our humanity. Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation. Through your goodness we have this wine to offer, fruit of the vine, work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Wash away my iniquities and cleanse me from my sins. Pray, my friends, that our sacrifice may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of all his church.
Grant, we pray, O Lord, that as promised by your Son, the Holy Spirit may reveal to us more abundantly the hidden mystery of the sacrifice, and graciously lead us into all truth, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For bringing your Paschal mystery to completion, you bestowed the Holy Spirit today on those you made your adopted children by uniting them to your only begotten Son. The same Spirit, as the Church came to birth, opened to all peoples the knowledge of God and brought together the many languages of the earth in profession of the one faith. Therefore, overcome with Paschal joy, every land, every people, exult in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You're indeed holy, O Lord, and all you've created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy, and you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread and, giving you thanks, said the blessing, broke the bread and gave it to the disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." He In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and, giving you thanks, said the blessing and gave the chalice to the disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church and recognizing the sacrificial victim, by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself. Grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with St. Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May the sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis our Pope, Bhuti our Archbishop, the Order of Bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you've gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honour is yours, for ever and ever.
Amen.
At the Saviour's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your Church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign for ever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, the one who takes away the sins of the world. How blessed are we who are called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
May the body and blood of Christ bring us life everlasting.
Amen.
Although you cannot receive physical communion with us now, we invite you into a moment of spiritual communion. The great medieval theologian, St. Thomas Aquinas, defined spiritual communion as an ardent desire to receive Jesus in the Holy Sacrament, and a loving embrace as though we had already received him. His words are echoed by the great mystic and fellow doctor of the Church, Saint Teresa of Avila, who wrote, "When you do not receive communion and do not attend Mass, you can make a spiritual communion, which is a most beneficial practice. By it, the love of God will be greatly impressed on you." At this moment, we invite you to focus on Christ and your longing for union with him. Express your desire to feel his grace coursing through you, giving you strength and courage, particularly in these difficult times. In your desiring union, you are united with us and to Christ. In this moment, we experience the reality that is already here.
Let us pray. O God, who bestow heavenly gifts upon your Church, safeguard, we pray, the grace you have given, and that the gift of the Holy Spirit poured out upon her may retain all its force, and that its spiritual food may gain her abundance of eternal redemption through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Today, of course, there's a special blessing. May God, the Father of lights, who is pleased to enlighten the disciples' minds by the outpouring of the Spirit, the Paraclete, grant you gladness by his blessing and make you always abound with the gifts of the same Spirit.
Amen.
May the wondrous flame that appeared above the disciples powerfully cleanse your hearts from every evil and pervade them with its purifying light.
Amen.
And may God, who has pleased to unite many tongues in the profession of one faith, give you perseverance in that same faith, and by believing may you journey from hope to clear vision.
Amen.
May the blessing of Almighty God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit come down upon you and remain with you forever.
Amen.
Our Mass has ended. Go in peace. Alleluia, alleluia.
Thanks be to God. Alleluia, alleluia.